Hello friends, welcome to my channel ELS, English Literature Studies with Kaur Harpreet. Today I am here with one more video on University Wits in which I will discuss Christopher Marlowe. This is my last video on University Wit as I have discussed each and every University Wit in detail. I have also discussed University Wits in which I have described their contribution to English drama in brief and how these University Wits prepared ground for Shakespeare, or we can say how they contributed to Elizabethan drama. That is also discussed in my previous videos. I've also discussed Dr. Faustus and Comical Element by Christopher Marlowe. Link will be provided about all these videos in the description box. If you want, you can also watch those videos. So today I will discuss Christopher Marlowe. So let us start. Christopher Marlowe, whose time period is 1564 to 1593. He is an English playwright, poet and translator of the Elizabethan era. He is called as the most talented of the pre-Shakespearean. He is also noted for his establishment of dramatic blank verse, and he has a great influence on William Shakespeare, and his influence on Shakespeare as described by Taylor like this: we can now be confident that they didn't just influence each other, but they worked with each other. Rivals sometimes collaborate. Christopher Marlowe's works include The Tragical History of the Life and Death of Dr. Faustus, which is commonly referred as Dr. Faustus. It is an Elizabethan tragedy which was written sometime between 1589 and 1592. His next work is The Massacre at Paris. Then G of Malta, which is also known as the famous tragedy of the rich G of Malta, Edward II. Then Dido, the Queen of Carthage, or the tragedy of Dido, Queen of Carthage. This is a short play which is written by Christopher Marlowe with possible contribution by another University wit, Thomas Nash. These are his important works. Now let us come to the main topic of this video, that is his contribution to English drama. How he contributed to English drama? Marlowe's contribution to English drama is very vital and manifold. He himself seems to be aware of having scored an advance over the previous drama. It is Marlowe, out of University Wits, who raised the subject matter of drama to a higher level. He provided a bit heroic subject that appealed to the imagination of the audience, and the subjects were grand. Marlowe dramatized the history of Tamburlaine, who is a world conqueror. And he also dramatized the history of Dr. Faustus, which is a necroman in pursuit of universal knowledge. For Senecan motive of revenge, he substituted the more interesting theme of ambition. For example, the ambition of power in Tamburlaine, the ambition for infinite in Dr. Faustus, the ambition for gold in the G of Malta. Marlowe gave life and reality to characters. The characters in his hands had no longer remained puppets, but living and breathing realities. He gave lifelike characters with fire. He put forward a new kind of tragic hero. Talking about his heroes like Tamburlaine, Dr. Faustus, they are very forceful heroes. They are full of energy and just for life. Marlowe made improvement in the form of tragedy, and he modified conception of tragedy which was held in the Middle Ages. If we talk about Middle Ages, tragedy was a thing of princes, whereas for Marlowe, tragedy was a method of individual hero. He revived Aristotle's conception of tragic hero. According to Marlowe, his heroes are all supermen whose major flaw is overambitiousness. The tragedy does not lie in mere fall, but in struggle between the overwhelming soul and its overwhelming ambition. Hence, Marlowe's tragedies show dramatic conflict between their ambitiousness and antagonist forces of life which fall in their way. But along with this outer conflict, there is inner conflict, which is very clear in Dr. Faustus, showing struggle between the mind of characters also. The medieval conception of tragedy was didactic, but in Marlowe's tragedies, there is no moral of this sort. He revolutionized the conception of tragedy and made it fit for the need and new urges of Renaissance. Marlowe is the first playwright to perceive that the tragedy begins and ends with the hero. His characterization is very simple. The heroes are individuals. They arouse sympathy in some degree, and their own nature is seed of their own fate. That is why Marlowe is known as the morning star of the Elizabethan drama. He imparted passion and force to drama. He sets the stage with passion. In Tamburlaine, the passion extends in the direction of world conquest. And in Dr. Faustus, this passion takes the form of conquest of secret forces of nature. In his another play, The Jew of Malta, this passion is noted for insatiable love for wealth. Marlowe added poetic grandeur and poetic excellence to drama also. He breathed into drama the life spirit of poetry. In place of rhyming verse, he introduced blank verse. He introduced several new tones into blank verse. He provided a new medium in which heroic actions could be expressed with the pomp of new style. Ben Jonson calls Marlowe's blank verse as Marlowe's mighty lines. And these mighty lines notable for its splendor, diction, picaresqueness, energy, variety in place, and responsiveness to demands of varying emotions. His dramatic poetry is full of vivid imagery from the classic, from astronomy and geography. And A.C. Swinburne calls him the father of English tragedy and creator of blank verse. Marlowe also reformed chronicle plays of his time. They were formless and pure in character. Marlowe humanized them. He handled the historical material artistically and judiciously selecting some, reflecting some, and modifying some to suit dramatic purpose. He had faith in retributive justice. According to him, all evildoers have to suffer for their misdeeds, and he has explained this retributive justice like this. Tamburlaine dies miserably, Faustus is condemned to eternal damnation, and King Edward, who neglected his knightly duties, is imprisoned and killed for misdeeds. Thus, the plays of Marlowe have an ethnical significance. He is the first dramatist who used the device of nemesis in an artistic and psychological manner. In conclusion, I would like to say the final note of Marlowe's tragedies like Tamburlaine and Dr. Faustus are elevating and not depressing, because they're about the dignity of man and his courage. So friends, this is all about my today's video, in which I've discussed Christopher Marlowe as a university wit and his contribution to English drama. I hope you will like my video, and if you like it, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. And if you are new on my channel, please hit the bell button to get notifications for upcoming videos. Thanks a lot for watching.